Welcome to PC Building Simulator 2, everyone. This game is currently in its beta, as you can see up here. And this beta lasts, if you see this on the day it comes out. This won't be out till after. Okay, never mind about that. But yeah, the beta lasts through this week only, so if y'all are new about the game's beta and played any of it, you know what to do about it. But yeah, if you played the beta, you get a 15% discount on the full version later on when it comes out later this year. And yeah, this game, it's upgraded a lot from what they did in the first one. They upgraded the graphics on things. You got way more case customization, like this one right here. Way better water-cooled lines running through. Just overall better everything. And so we're going to pop back into free build, and I'm just going to put something together, and we're just going to do that real quick. Just because I think if I have access to the beta, I should play around with it. But yeah, this is the free build shop they give you. It's got a decent amount of space to walk around in. Well, like I said, it's a beta. There will be a few bugs. But yeah, you got the whole area. This is probably where PCs get dropped off if you're running like the in-game shop. Where's my PC? I don't remember, but we're gonna come into here and access the storage. Oh, there's no in here. Okay. Got it. Now let me do what I want! Okay. I'll put that down, and now I just want... Okay, I guess I have to go here. Alright, yeah. This is where I wanted to go, not the other cabinet. Yeah, right now in the beta, they've got just this small selection of cases and stuff to build from. And I frankly kind of want to snag... Let's go with the Fractal Meshify 2, because I've actually seen this one be built in quite a lot, so... Actually, that's the wrong booth. I want to put it over here. The side panels... And it's already got fans in the front, so I don't need to remove any of that. But we're going to install a motherboard, and... We're going to go with, do they have X570? Yes, they do. Alright, cool. So yeah, we're going to grab an X570 board. We're going to grab the, let's grab the Godlike MSI, because, well, that one is probably a pretty good option. Move the screen over more. Get this out of here. Yeah, and the free build here, it sticks in all the screws for you, but in the career you'll have to go through and manage everything yourself. There's probably a setting to turn it off, but because it's a beta, I'm not going to bother going through that. And you get your CPU processor. For this one, we'll go 5950, because let's just build a super high-end system here today. Put the CPU in the socket, close the retention arm, put some thermal paste on there, and the thermal paste application here is cool, because you can just coat the whole frickin' thing. So you can kind of see how your thermal paste applications do. And to those of you in the comments who are going to say that's way too much thermal paste and you shouldn't be doing it, relax, it's a game and I don't care. Alright, that tube's empty. And it says sufficient paste applied. Alright, next we're going to install our memory, because in my opinion, memory... depending on your cooler, memory might be hard or near impossible to install if you get a bad cooler. And as far as memory modules go, I was going to look for a different kind, but I guess they don't have it in here yet. But I guess we'll just snag these ones, because they're really high capacity DIMM sticks. And you got to open all the RAM slots. That That one. That one. And that one. Alright, and now we're going to grab a cooler. And for this, we're just going to snag... let's go with the 240 here, and we can... Okay. Go with the 240. Yeah, we're not going through the hassle of removing all that. I'll go with the 120. Or rather, I'll get the... this, whatever this cooler is. We'll plug that one in. Alright. And next up, we want to stick in a M.2 storage drive. For example, I will grab the Patriot, the XPG 1TB drive here. I'll put it right into there. Put that cover back on. And we'll grab a graphics card. We'll go 3090, because why the crap not? And I think this one will fit. And it won't. Oh yeah, I gotta remove the slots. I forgot, it's a 3-slot. There we go. And that fits all perfect there. Connect all the case fans up. Install a power supply. Let's go with a 1600 watt Corsair unit, because why not? In there. Removed components. Oh, geez. PSU mount. You see, that's something that does happen when the cables are auto plugged in. Okay, it plugged itself back in. Cool. Panel, dust filter, add the dust filter in here, the top panel back on, okay, it does work. I was just trying to think of if I missed anything. Side panel on. Side panel on. Power it off. Power it on, and behold. Behold. Okay. RAM OC on, apply changes and restart, there we go, that's the drive I was looking for. In the other game, that's all their USB drives at the back are all the same, so it didn't matter which one you clicked over there, but I guess over here it does matter. Anywho. That was just a quick show build of how you can put together a PC in this game. And something else I've learned is once you build it, you can bring it over here. And you have full range to rotate. We can grab the spray paint can, make it a real big nozzle. Let's say you want a big blue, and you can just go like that or like that. Maybe you want to do an orange streak here too. Some hot rod red in the corners. Maybe you, and I would not recommend spraying your case with components in them ever, especially if you wanted to say do something like paint this panel, because you can totally do that. You can totally paint and create whatever colors and tones you like. Like, for say, if I wanted to do that, that, and that, with some of that and that in the corner. That's a pretty good looking case. It's just got this subtle RGB feeling to it, even though all the components inside are no RGB really. But yeah, all the customizations you can get throughout it. You can do all sorts of things. You can get like get different cityscapes and different things you can grab and apply. Put that on there as a wrap. You can put it on the glass panes. You can put stickers on. Just like, you know, if you wanted to slap a big air-cooled logo on there, or sick, or bad man nurse. You know, anything like that. But yeah, I just thought this was a really cool addition to the game. Like, having full paint booth and customizing with different stickers, paint cans, the printer back there that looks like a Cricut, and those Cricut sticker printers. Yeah, but yeah. Anywho, that's where I'm going to leave this video. I hope you have enjoyed. If you have, hit the like button, subscribe, and notification bell. And you can catch me later this year playing this game on the full version to replace my PC Building Simulator 1 videos, because I think this game could step those up just a good notch enough to play and have some really cool PC builds. I've got a lot of decent ideas to test out in here that, if I had the money, I might recreate some of them in real life. Anywho, bye!